Great state of Wisconsin, from Milwaukee County. Now, Sheriff David Clarke speaking tonight.
Is dedicated to grants for your own state. I want you to consider the local impact of these law enforcement grants. You've heard from my friend Jonathan Thompson. He lives nearby in the city of Falls Church. I want to tell you about another local resident, Dr. Ron May, who is the director of trauma anesthesia at a leading hospital in the area. He's also a sworn reserve deputy sheriff with 14 years of service. Doctor, thank you for your service to your community. Now, if you ask Dr. Bank how he's able to commit to service as a deputy sheriff on top of his medical practice, he will tell you that it would not be possible with, first, a very supportive wife, and second, the benefit of the highest caliber training to maintain his skills as a medical doctor and as a law enforcement professional. As a doctor, he completed his anesthesia critical care training as well as a cardiac anesthesia fellowship at the Johns Hopkins Hospital in Baltimore, Maryland. To serve side by side with his fellow deputies, Dr. Bank has completed training in handling active shooters, low and no light marksmanship, tactical shooting, shotguns, patrol rifles, pistols, and more. If you were a wounded victim of a crime, isn't Dr. Ron Bank one of the deputies you hope arrives at the scene? Much of his law enforcement training would not have been possible without grants from the NRA Foundation. In fact, some of his most valuable skills were provided tuition-free thanks to the NRA Foundation. Dr. Ron Bank is living proof that what we do here tonight will help him and his fellow law enforcement officers make America safe and make America great again. Deputy Bank, please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Dr. Ron Bank to our banquet. Again, Doctor, thank you for your service to your community. I'm glad to have the chance to honor Dr. Bank, but I know he is here to support the full range of grants of the NRA Foundation, which promote, advance, and encourage firearms, shooting sports, and hunting safety, educate individuals with respect to firearms and firearms history, participation in shooting sports, hunting safety, and marksmanship, along with conducting research and furtherance of improved firearm safety and marksmanship facilities and techniques. You see, the funds we raise tonight will help people across the national capital area and throughout the United States. It will help children, youth, women, individuals with physical disabilities, gun collectors, law enforcement officers, hunters, and competitive shooters. Without supporting those stakeholders, how can we preserve the Second Amendment? It becomes very difficult. How can we make America safe and make America great again without supporting goals like that of the NRA Foundation? Now you might ask, what can you do to help? I hereby deputize each and every one of you as members of the National Capital Friends of the NRA, and I want you to join me and Dr. Bank in raising money for the NRA Foundation here tonight. In closing, just I have called for us all to stand together. I want you to know that law enforcement stands by you and with you. Law enforcement critics try to hurt our honor. They try to shame us for doing our job. They teach children to fear us, crowds to attack us, and good people to doubt us. But we will never back down from our sworn duty to uphold the Constitution of the United States of America. You see, we wake up every day, we put on our star badge, we strap a gun to our hips, kiss our families goodbye,
and put our lives between the law-abiding and the criminal who threaten your rights. We serve people of every color and creed, men, women, and children in violent, dangerous neighborhoods. Because they have the same right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness as CEOs, movie stars, and the political elite. Yeah. Yeah. We are Americans, we are you, and as proven by Dr. Bang, you are us. We are America's law enforcement. We stand with you, and the NRA Foundation stands with us, and we appreciate that. Thank you. God bless you. God bless our efforts. God bless the men and women of law enforcement, and may God continue to bless these United States of America. Thank you.